At American Safeguard Insurance, you get an actual human being just down the street to get advice on the confusing world of insurance. There's no need to shop around every time your insurance company tries to raise rates. You can relax and let us do it for you. Having a choice is a big deal, and when insurance companies compete, you save money. One of the most important benefits is we actually monitor your premium for rate increases. If we notice a rate increase, we reshop your premium to ensure the best rate. And when the time comes to use your insurance, and we hope it doesn't, you have a friend to help guide you during one of the most stressful times of your life. All your needs under one roof, from vehicle to life insurance, and everything in between. We protect it all.
Took a 911 about 107 down a back road.
Hey folks, Sean Gorham here for Cowboy Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs, the Lake Area's fastest growing GM dealership, where we make your car buying experience easy and enjoyable. Simply shop cowboycbg.com, where you can pick out your vehicle, get an appraisal, pre-approval, and even purchase from your living room. Every new vehicle purchased comes with a complimentary 7-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, and we deliver anywhere in the state. The service don't stop there. We also have a state-of-the-art service facility and collision repair center. So for all your automotive needs, come see us at Cowboy Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs.
Family Disco Pharmacy has been serving the Greers Ferry Lake area since 1976. They are located on the back side of the Court Square in downtown Heber Springs. Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy offers private consultations, Medicare enrollment, and immunizations for pneumonia, flu, COVID, shingles, tetanus, and more. They also test and treat strep and flu. Their staff is committed to providing fast and friendly service. Stop by today to see why Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy is Greers Ferry Lake's number one independent pharmacy. FL Davis is more than just a hardware store. With six locations to serve you in Heber Springs, Greers Ferry, Sherwood, Pea Ridge, Fayetteville, and Centerton, they are your one-stop shop for hardware and home improvement. They are also the home of the Lake Boutique, featuring clothing, footwear, jewelry, accessories, baby items, home decor, and kitchen items. Whether you're building a new home, improving your old one, or needing a gift for yourself or someone else, stop by one of their locations and experience all that they have to offer. Physical Therapy in Heber Springs is a proud supporter of the Lake Area Athletes. If you or your student athlete are looking to get back in shape or for therapy after an injury, give Ivy Physical Therapy a call at 501-362-8118 or visit ivyphysicaltherapy.com.
And now, Cap Truss, they specialize in installation and creation of custom wood trusses for your home or business. Knapp Truss utilizes only premier lumber to ensure our products last. When you come to Knapp Truss, you will have the peace of mind knowing you're receiving the best quality construction for the best price in the area. Knapp Truss staff members have years in the industry and know what it takes to install a quality truss from the start to finish. Call Knapp Truss at 870-948-2105 today.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night.
All right, we're back. Mount Vernon Enola High School, your score 38-9. The Lady Warhawks lead the Lady Redhawks of Nemo Vista. Here's Marley Raby with the ball, taking it down the court.
And our apologies to all of you watching at home. We've had some technical difficulties here tonight with internet. Of course, you know, glorious technology, and we sometimes we do have those technical difficulties, and our apologies is all we can offer. And just forgiveness is all we can ask.
Shot put up, no good. That was Perkins for the Redhawks. Rebounded Warhawks. Here's Raby. She drives inside to McCarty. McCarty's going to put it in.
Yes, she is. Desi McCarty having another banner night. Redhawks just don't have the answer for another steal. Corey Kyle ahead to Person. She's got the advantage. One link lead. She'll get the easy two.
Here's Perkins bringing it down the floor for the Redhawks. She's going to pass it over number 12, Baker, who just came in this half. DeSalvo with the ball, looking to shoot. She passes instead, and the pass is going to sail over the head of number 44, Hammett. And it looks like the starters for Mount Vernon Enola are being taken out of the game for a little bit of breath of fresh air.
You've got Olivia McClellan, Jordan Rogers, Alyssa Gilbert, Charity Pruitt on the floor for the Warhawks, and Corey Kyle.
Lissa Gilbert's driving, and she passes it back out.
Charity Pruitt, the only senior on this Warhawk team. McClellan, a junior. And Rogers, Gilbert, and Corey Kyle, sophomores.
Lissa Gilbert makes the three for the Warhawks. And the ball is going to be out of bounds. Stay in possession of the Lady Redhawks. 45-9, 5 minutes, 48 seconds to play in the third quarter.
Great ball movement. Wide open three. Just can't get it to go.
Shooting odds have not seemed to be in the favor of the Lady Redhawks tonight.
They've had a tough evening, Jacob. This Garris, her shot has been off tonight. I couldn't get her threes to fall, couldn't get her free throws to fall. Very uncharacteristic for KK Garris and these Lady Redhawks.
Pass inside to DeSalvo. She kicks it back out. That's Baker with the ball at the key now. And looking to pass inside, she does, but it's going to get kicked back out, and there's going to be a foul called. Foul on number 11 of the Warhawks, Olivia McClellan. At the line, shooting two for the Redhawks, we have Perkins. Her first one's up and no good, and here's her second on the way, also no good.
Lady Redhawks switched ends, and they're struggling on both sides of the court, Jack. It's just not their night.
Wide open three-pointer from Alyssa Gilbert is good.
The sophomore can shoot. That's two. Alyssa Gilbert is drained.
Here's a three-point shot on the way. No good from Baker. It's going to go out of bounds on the Lady Redhawks, and it'll be Warhawk basketball.
4 minutes, 34 seconds left to go here in this third quarter.
Jaylee Belote's going to check back into the game for the Warhawks. Here's another three-point shot. No good this time from Gilbert. Belote with the ball as the Warhawks are going to get it back. Here's a shot in the corner from Pruitt. It's good.
Great ball movement there by the Warhawks, finding the senior wide open in that corner. Charity Pruitt taking advantage and drains the three.
And that'll put the Lady Warhawks past the half-century mark. 51-9, 3 minutes and 52 seconds to go in the third quarter. Gilbert, pass. Now here's Pruitt with the ball. Back to Gilbert. Good ball movement here by the Warhawks. Shot on the way, no good from Jordan Rogers. And the Warhawks rebound it. Pruitt's pass back to Rogers.
Warhawks, they're distributing the ball. I was about to say very well, but they did. Then they just throw it away. Nobody was home on that one. But before that, they were moving it, passing it very efficiently.
Perkins with the drive. She's going to pass it out. Baker's going to come away with it. Her pass inside to DeSalvo. DeSalvo looking for what to do with the ball. She doesn't know. She passes it back out. And the three-point basket from Baker's no good. Foul's going to be called on Jaylee Belote. That's her third foul. Second team foul this half for the Warhawks. And the free throw is good from Perkins. Here's Perkins' second on the way. It's up and in. Pruitt bringing it down the floor for the Warhawks. Lissa Gilbert's going to drive and take it in. She's going to get hit in the mouth. There's going to be no call.
Took quite a shot there from the shoulder.
Pruitt. He's going to drive. The drive by Pruitt's good for two.
Great job by Charity Pruitt. Warhawks moving the ball effectively. The old give and go. She caught the opportunity straight up the gut. Easy two.
Pass inside. Inside the lane. It's going to be batted around several times by several different players. Just kind of gets loose in there, and it's going to come away. The Redhawks are still going to have it. There's a shot in the corner. Three-point basket. That's Alyssa Williams, the three-point basket for the Lady Redhawks. Maybe that means their shooting is going to start to waken up here in the third quarter, but there's Charity Pruitt with three.
The senior is showing out. 9 points for Charity Pruitt on the night.
Baker with the ball now for the Lady Redhawks. Looking for something to do with it. She's being guarded pretty good by Pruitt. 3-point basket from Perkins is no good.
Rebound by McClellan. Kick to Gilbert.
Ooh!
Too many red jerseys. Stop, turn it around. Lady Red Hawk took a spill right there.
Here's a three-point shot from Alyssa Gilbert. Off the tip of the rim, no good. Rebounded by the Red Hawks.
Two seconds.
The Red Hawks have to get a shot off, and they don't. And that's the end of the third quarter. The score 56-14 here in Mount Vernon Enola High School. And the Lady Warhawks have a commanding lead over the Red Hawks of Nemo Vista. We'll take a timeout here, and we'll be back with some fourth quarter action for you. This is Lake Area Sports. Don't go away.
Tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I feel it. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night.
What do you do with your Ram truck? Are you pulling a trailer? Pulling a boat to the lake to enjoy some time with your family, or are you enjoying nature and taking your Ram off-road? Whatever you're doing with your Ram, Red River Dodge of Heber Springs has the Ram for you.
And you know what they say, you can't believe everything you see on the internet. And that's true right now. Not every new Ram truck that we have is showing up online. Go to our website at redriverdodge.com and let us get what you want right to your front doorstep. Or make that beautiful drive to Heber Springs during...
All right, we're back to open the fourth quarter as the Lady Warhawks 56-14 lead over the Red Hawks of Nemo Vista.
Mercy rule is in effect. Clock will not stop.
Pass out of bounds by the Red Hawks. It's going to be Warhawk basketball. Pruitt with the ball. Coming down the court. Pass over to Belote. Inside. And Pruitt's going to get with it again. And the pass inside is put up. No good. That was a shot by number 20, Jordan Rogers. For the Warhawks.
And a foul's going to be committed by Olivia McClellan.
That'll send Crabtree to the line to shoot two.
Second personal foul on McClellan. Three on the Warhawks this half. You look up there at the scoreboard. The Redhawks started off the first half a little rough. Picked up three fouls within a minute and a half of the opening quarter. They have zero fouls on them this second half.
And here's the second free throw on the way from Crabtree. It's no good, as was the first. Two-point play results in nothing. And the Warhawks will have the basketball. And they'll play a little bit more of the passing game. Here's a shot. Up, no good. Rebounded by the Warhawks, put up again by Rogers. No good. Rogers gets it back. And here's Belote with the shot this time. No good. Rebounded by Pruitt. Oh, Pruitt's going to give it away. Here's a drive. Hammett puts it up and in. And Belote with the ball. She passes it across to Pruitt. Pruitt's going to drive. Jump shot. In.
Charity Pruitt.
Nice little pull-up jumper there by Charity Pruitt.
Very much so.
Taken away once again by the Lady Warhawks. Belote with the ball. Over to the corner. And it's going to be passed back to Belote. Still some more passing game here from the Lady Warhawks. Trying to eat some time off the clock. And pass is intercepted. And the Lady Redhawks are going to come away with it. And looks like the Redhawks are going to get away this time. Belote with the ball. Over to Pruitt. Pruitt looking to shoot her pass. She'll pass it over. And the layup. Alyssa Gilbert drives in, finds the ball, and puts it up for two. And that ball is going to be thrown out of bounds by the Lady Redhawks. Clock is running. It's 3 minutes and 50 seconds to play in the game. 60-16, the lead. Mount Vernon Enola Lady Warhawks over the Lady Redhawks of Nemo Vista. There's a shot in the corner coming from Corey Kyle. It's no good, but there's going to be a foul on the following play. They're going to call that on number 25, Chloe Crabtree of the Redhawks. That'll send Cherry Pruitt to the line, shoot two. Her first one's in and out. It's Crabtree's first foul. Team's first foul this half. The second free throw's up and in. And here's the shot. In and out, no good. From the Redhawks, number four, that was Perkins.
Great try.
And there's Corey Kyle.
Just taking it to the house.
She's going to be called. That's going to be an old-fashioned three-point play.
If she can get it to go. The old-fashioned three-point opportunity.
And here's the free throw. No good. So it'll result in two for the Lady Warhawks. And that's going to be out of bounds once again on the Redhawks. Warhawk basketball. Guess you could call tonight the Battle of the Hawks.
Battle of the Hawks. One's red, one's blue.
Here's Belote with the ball now. The pass inside. Belote and...
Nice offensive possession. Great ball movement, dishing down to McClellan. Turns and looks. There's Alyssa Gilbert wide open.
And the Redhawks still being heavily guarded. There's Belote. Redhawks now passing the ball around. Got to get a shot off. Here's a shot from Hammett. It's no good. And here's going to come away with it the Warhawks. Belote with the ball. Over to Pruitt. Pruitt looks to drive. No good. She's stopped. Belote looking inside. There's Pruitt inside. She's going to drive and put it up. She'll be fouled. Call that foul on number 23 of the Redhawks. And the first free throw is good from Pruitt. Second one on the way, and it'll fall in. '67-16, shot clock's been turned off. 20 seconds to play. And the Redhawks pass saved, but it'll go in favor of the Warhawks. They'll dribble it around. Belote over to Pruitt. And that'll be the ball game as the Lady Warhawks are going to hold it. And they dominated this game, 67-16. The final score here at Mount Vernon Enola High School. Guess we'll be back with some boys action here in a few moments. From Lake Area Sports, I'm Jacob Cater.
And Josh Moss.
All right. We'll take a break. Don't go away, folks.
What do you do with your Ram truck? Are you pulling a trailer? Pulling a boat to the lake to enjoy some time with your family? Or are you enjoying nature and taking your Ram off-road? Whatever you're doing with your Ram, Red River Dodge of Heber Springs has the Ram for you.
And you know what they say, you can't believe everything you see on the internet. And that's true right now. Not every new Ram truck that we have is showing up online. Go to our website at redriverdodge.com and let us get what you want right to your front doorstep. Or make that beautiful drive to Heber Springs during Ram Power Day.
Nobody has sold more Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram vehicles than the Landers family. If you're looking for a hassle-free, stress-free buying experience, then Cowboy Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram in Clint is your place to shop. We've got all the trucks you're looking for with brand new V8 Ram trucks starting at just $29,988. If there's a job to be done, we've got the truck for it. Ram 2500, 3500, gas or diesel, crew cab, mega cab, or cab and chassis. We've got all the trucks. Nobody will beat a Cowboy deal on your next Jeep with up to $5,000 off or an available 0% interest. Shop us today. Jeep Gladiator, Wrangler, Grand Cherokee, Wagoneer. It's all in stock and ready to deliver. If you want to pay too much, buy somewhere else. If you want the car deal you've always waited for, Cowboy Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Clinton is your place to shop. It's quick and easy. Jump online at cowboycdjr.com or give us a call at 501-745-5333. Cowboy up or you'll pay too much.
At American Safeguard Insurance, you get an actual human being just down the street to get advice on the confusing world of insurance. There's no need to shop around every time your insurance company tries to raise rates. You can relax and let us do it for you. Having a choice is a big deal, and when insurance companies compete, you save money. One of the most important benefits is we actually monitor your premium for rate increases. If we notice a rate increase, we reshop your premium to ensure the best rate. And when the time comes to use your insurance, and we hope it doesn't, you have a friend to help guide you during one of the most stressful times of your life. All your needs under one roof, from vehicle to life insurance, and everything in between. We protect it all.
Took a 911 about 107 down a back road. Well, the White River runs and the Southern Sun makes a good new road.
Hey folks, Sean Gorham here for Cowboy Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs, the Lake Area's fastest growing GM dealership, where we make your car buying experience easy and enjoyable. Simply shop cowboyscbg.com, where you can pick out your vehicle, get an appraisal, pre-approval, and even purchase from your living room. Every new vehicle purchased comes with a complimentary 7-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, and we deliver anywhere in the state. The service don't stop there. We also have a state-of-the-art service facility and collision repair center. So for all your automotive needs, come see us at Cowboys Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs.
Family Disco Pharmacy has been serving the Greers Ferry Lake area since 1976. They are located on the back side of the Court Square in downtown Heber Springs. Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy offers private consultations, Medicare enrollment, and immunizations for pneumonia, flu, COVID, shingles, tetanus, and more. They also test and treat strep and flu. Their staff is committed to providing fast and friendly service. Stop by today to see why Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy is Greers Ferry Lake's number one independent pharmacy. FL Davis is more than just a hardware store, with six locations to serve you in Heber Springs, Greers Ferry, Sherwood, Pea Ridge, Fayetteville, and Centerton. They are your one-stop shop for hardware and home improvement. They are also the home of the Lake Boutique, featuring clothing, footwear, jewelry, accessories, baby items, home decor, and kitchen items. Whether you're building a new home, improving your old one, or needing a gift for yourself or someone else, stop by one of their locations and experience all that they have to offer. Physical Therapy in Heber Springs is a proud supporter of the Lake Area Athletes. If you or your student athlete are looking to get back in shape or for therapy after an injury, give Ivy Physical Therapy a call at 501-362-8118 or visit ivyphysicaltherapy.com.
Knapp Truss, they specialize in installation and creation of custom wood trusses for your home or business. Knapp Truss utilizes only premier lumber to ensure our products will last. When you come to Knapp Truss, you will have the peace of mind knowing you're receiving the best quality construction for the best price in the area. Knapp Truss staff members have years in the industry and know what it takes to install a quality truss from the start finish. Call Knapp Truss at 870-948-2105 today.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good
night. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Lake Area Sports, we're here live from Mount Vernon Enola High School, Mount Vernon, Arkansas, as we get ready for some boys action this evening. The Warhawks taking on the Red Hawks of Nemo Vista. Starting lineups, number two, Tav Henry. This is for the Warhawks. Number two, Tav Henry. Number 13, Logan Lloyd. Number 33, Cody Hoover. Number 30, Dakota Walls. Number one, Kyler Chapman. For the Nemo Vista Red Hawks, We have number 3, Caleb Freeman. Number 11, Patrick Perry. Number 22, Braden Hill. Number 21, Kobe Best. And number 30, Jack Andrews. And players will take the court as the tip-off is underway. Perry and Chapman in the side of the circle. Looks like Perry's got to win the tip-off for the Redhawks. Here's the shot from Freeman in the corner. Freeman for 3 to open this game up. Chapman passes it over in the corner, and it's blocked by Perry. Perry underneath the goal. He denied Dakota Walls. Condry's going to drive. Here's the shot from Andrews. Andrews with the 3. Back-to-back three-pointers for the Redhawks to get things started here in Mount Vernon. And the Warhawks are going to drive. That drive put up by number 13, Logan Lloyd. It's going to be no good. Perry's going to bring the ball down past the timeline. Perry looking for a pass. He'll give it to Hill. Hill over to Freeman in the corner. Hill fakes. He'll put it up inside the arch. No good. It'll go out of bounds on the Warhawks. Stay Red Hawk basketball. 6-0 to score. 6 minutes, 50 seconds to play in the first quarter. Here's Condry with the drive. Kicks out to Hill. Hill to Perry. Perry looking for the play call. He's going to drive, spin move, kicks it back out to Hill. Hill over to Andrews. Andrews to Freeman. Hill in the corner for 3. No good, off the rim. Rebounded by Cody Hoover. And the Warhawks will have the ball on their end of the floor now. Here's Chapman with the ball. He looks to pass. He's going to take it a little bit over. Passes inside. Pull-up jumper from Dakota Walls is no good. He's going to pass it out. It's going to be tipped off by Nemo Vista, but they're going to call a foul. Foul will be on number 22. That's Braden Hill. Hill's first. The team's first. The inbound from the Warhawks. Pull-up shot on the weak side. No good. Here's Perry with the ball. Perry drives and lays it in off the fingers. Pat Perry. 8-0 Red Hawks. Now here's the Warhawks' turn. Hoover over to Henry. Henry to Chapman. And that ball is going to be out of bounds. We're going to call that out on last touch by Hill. Inbounds it to Chapman. It's denied by Perry. And they're going to call a charge on Chapman. Kyler Chapman, offensive foul. That's his first foul, team's first foul. Freeman's going to be there to inbound the ball to Andrews. Andrews will bring it across half court. Here's Pat Perry with 3. Pat Perry for 3. Patrick Perry starting tonight off hot for the Redhawks. Here's Tav Henry with the ball now for the Warhawks. Passing it around. Henry with the ball once again. He's looking to drive, and he'll kick it out to Logan Lloyd. Cody Hoover comes around. Lloyd gets it back once again. He drives inside. He'll give it to Cody Hoover underneath the basketball, but he's going to be denied by Perry. Perry's going to take it to the other coast. and he's going to get the and one. The drive by Pat Perry is good, and they're going to say he was fouled on the shot. They'll call that foul number two, Pat Perry, and the Warhawks are going to take a timeout. 13-0 your score. We'll take timeout along with them. Don't go away, folks. This is Lake Area Sports. We've got a great basketball game. We'll be right back.
That tonight's going to be a good, good night. I feel it. That tonight's going to be a good night. That tonight's going to be a good night.
What do you do with your Ram truck? Are you pulling a trailer? Pulling a boat to the lake to enjoy some time with your family, or are you enjoying nature and taking your Ram off-road?
All right, we're back. 13-point lead for the Red Hawks of Nemo Vista here at Mount Vernon Enola, home of the Warhawks. And Pat Perry, old-fashioned three-point play is good. It's 14-0 now. And the Warhawks are still trying to put some points on the board. The drive by Cody Hoover, he puts it up, it's no good, but he'll be fouled on the shot. He'll get to go to the charity stripe and shoot two. Gonna call that foul on Condry. And the first free throw is up and in, and that's gonna put Mount Vernon Enola on the board. Cody Hoover at the line. Shooting two, his second one on the way. It's no good. Rebound by Hill. Andrews with the ball now. He'll pass it ahead to Hill. Looking for a pass inside to Perry. It gets away from him. And the drive by Logan Lloyd's no good. Cody Hoover's going to put it back up and in, though. 14-3 now. 3 minutes, 55 seconds in the opening quarter left. Andrews with the ball, pass over to Condry. Condry, pull-up jump shot from the left side, no good, off the rim. Chapman gets the rebound for the Warhawks. Logan Lloyd passes it inside to Taff Henry. Taff Henry puts it up for the and one. That'll put Taff Henry at the line. Shooting a free throw. That foul called on Freeman. And the free throw is good. Here's the three-point basket for Condry. Condry with the corner three. They found him there coming down the court, and he shot it, and it was good. 17-6, the score now. Here's the pass inside to Walls. Walls turns, spin move, gets the rebound. Can't get it again. He'll put it back up again, and he'll be fouled that time. I believe they're going to call that foul at number 11, Pat Perry. Dakota Walls will go to the line to shoot two. Here's the shot. From Walls, first one's no good. Walls' second, it's on the way, it's in and out, no good. Rebound by Hill. Hill's gonna give it over to Perry, and he'll come across half court with it. Perry passes inside to Condry. Condry can't get it in time. Chapman's gonna come away with the ball. And the drive, no good. Cody Hoover. Hoover will be fouled. They're going to call that foul on Condry. Cody Hoover at the line to shoot two for the Warhawks. His first one's on the way, and it's up and in. That makes Nemo Vista's lead 10 points now. And the second free throw on the way is no good. Rebound by Hill. Here comes Andrews with the ball. He's going to pass it over to Condrey in the corner. Condrey back to Andrews at the key. And he'll find Hill in the corner. Hill shoots three. It's no good. Rebound by Dakota Walls. Chapman's going to bring it across half court for the Warhawks. And Cody Hoover looking to drive. He'll pass it back out. And it finds its way back to Hoover. Hoover for three. Cody Hoover. And that'll put the Warhawks in the double digits. It's 10-17. Nemo Vista with a 7-point lead. And Nemo Vista is going to call a timeout. We'll take it with them. Don't go away, folks. Great basketball here on a Thursday night from Mount Vernon High School. We'll be right back. This is Lake Area Sports.
Whatever you're doing with your Ram, Red River Dodge of Heber Springs has the Ram for you.
And you know what they say, you can't believe everything you see on the internet. And that's true right now. Not every new Ram truck that we have is showing up online. Go to our website at redriverdodge.com and let us get what you want right to your front doorstep. Or make that beautiful drive to Heber Springs during Ram Power Day.
And we're back here on Lake Area Sports, live from Mount Vernon Enola High School. Pat Perry with the inbound to Andrews. It's a great night for some high school basketball action as the 1A Nemo Vista Redhawks take on the 2A, recently moved to 2A, Warhawks of Mount Vernon Enola. Pat Perry shoots three, and it comes up a little short off the tip of the rim. Hoover with the ball now. Hoover with the drive. Puts it up, kicks it out. And the kick out once again. Here's Tav Henry with the shot. No good. Rebounded by Logan Lloyd. Logan Lloyd's going to shoot it for three. It's no good. And the Warhawks save it from going out of bounds, but it's going to fall back into the hands of their opponent. Condrey looking to shoot. He's going to drive. He kicks it across the lane to Hill. Hill puts it inside. Number 21, Kobe Bess. 2 points. And here's a three-point shot on the way. It's no good from Cody Hoover, but the Warhawks are going to get the basketball back, and Kyler Chapman pulls up to make 2 points. Hill in the corner with the ball. He's going to pass it back to the key to Andrews. Condrey looking to drive. Condrey passes it inside. It's going to be batted away by some Warhawks, and the Warhawks are going to come away with the basketball. Here's the drive. Spin move floater by Cody Hoover. Cody Hoover with 2 more points, it's 19-14. 5-point lead for Nemo Vista as the Warhawks are slowly chipping in. And Patrick Perry with the drive, no good. He kicks it out. It gets away from Bess. And as time expires, Cody Hoover lays it in coast to coast. That'll make it a 3-point basketball game going into the second quarter. It's 16-19. And we'll take a brief timeout. We'll come back with some second quarter action for you. Don't go away, folks. We've got a great basketball game here tonight. This is Lake Area Sports. We'll be right back.
Nobody has sold more Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram vehicles than the Landers family. If you're looking for a hassle-free, stress-free buying experience, then Cowboy Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram in Clint is your place to shop. We've got all the trucks you're looking for with brand new V8 Ram trucks starting at just $29,988. If there's a job to be done, we've got the truck for it. Ram 2500, 3500, gas or diesel, crew cab, mega cab, or cab and chassis. We've got all the trucks. Nobody will beat a Cowboy.
All right, we're back to begin the second quarter of basketball here in this boys' matchup between the Nemo Vista Redhawks and the Mount Vernon Enola Warhawks. Battle of the Hawks here in Mount Vernon Enola High School. Chapman at the key for the Warhawks with the ball. He'll bring it across the timeline, and it's batted out of bounds by the Redhawks. It's going to stay in possession of the Warhawks. Inbound and kickball. That's going to be Warhawks basketball once again. Chapman will inbound this time. He'll pass it to Hoover. Hoover over to Henry. And Chapman thought about shooting the three. He fakes, shoots the three instead. And Chapman, big three-point basket. That's going to tie the ball game at 19. Andrews with the ball now for the Redhawks. Passes it over. Freeman, Hill to Henry. Perry's going to step out of bounds as he couldn't balance himself. And ball's back in possession of the Warhawks. 19-19, 7 minutes, 15 seconds to play in the half. Full court press by the Redhawks now. And the pass inside is batted away by the Redhawks. It'll be inbounded by Chapman. Chapman's going to inbound it. Here's a three-point shot on the way. No good. They're going to call a three-point foul, though, on number 21, Colby Bess. That'll send Cody Hoover to the line to shoot three for the Warhawks. Shot from Hoover on the way. His first one's up and in. Here's the second one on the way from Hoover. Second of three. It's in. And here's Hoover's third and final opportunity. Up and in. Hoover, three for three from the free throw line. Makes it 22-19. That's the Warhawks' first lead this game. They started off a little cold, but then came back alive. And here's Hill with the drive for the Redhawks. Andrews back to Hill. Over to Freeman. He'll pass it inside to Perry in the lane. Perry puts it up, but he's going to be fouled. The shot was no good. He'll be fouled by Cody Hoover. Pat Perry's going to be at the line shooting two. That's Hoover's first foul. Team's third foul. Perry's first free throw is on the way. It's up and in. And Perry's second is good. 21-22. It's a one-point ball game. Nemo Vista takes the ball away. Chapman's going to get it back for the Warhawks. And the Warhawks are going to call a timeout before the 10-second violation's called. So we'll take the timeout with them. Don't go away, folks. We'll be right back.
Deal on your next Jeep with up to $5,000 off or an available 0% interest. Shop us today. Jeep Gladiator, Wrangler, Grand Cherokee, Wagoneer. It's all in stock and ready to deliver. If you want to pay too much, buy somewhere else. If you want the car deal you've always waited for, Cowboy Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Clinton is your place to shop. It's quick and easy. Jump online at cowboycdjr.com or give us a call at 501-745-5333. Cowboy up or you'll pay too much.
All right, we're back coming out of the timeout. 6 minutes, 27 seconds left to play in the half. The home team, Mount Vernon Enola Warhawks, lead it by one, 22-21. Yeah, Lloyd inbounds it to Chapman. Back to Lloyd, Lee being double teamed. Some hard man-to-man press here from the Redhawks, and Pat Perry's gonna get the rebound and pass it all the way up the court to Hill. Hill on the shot. There was no foul call. They're just gonna call that out of bounds. But the ball will be given back to the Redhawks. 33 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Freeman from the corner. He'll pass it inside to Perry. Perry dribbles, passes it back out. And Freeman fakes the three and passes to Hill. Hill over to Freeman once again. Freeman's going to shoot it this time. Freeman for three. And just like that, the Nemo Vista Redhawks have a two-point lead. Cody Hoover's pass over to the corner and back out to Chapman. Chapman's going to pass it into the corner. Walls shoots it, no good. And there's going to be a basket put in by Tav Henry to tie the game at 24. Freeman with the ball. Up to Andrews, over to Hill. Here's Freeman for three. Freeman's three-point off the back of the rim. And the Warhawks will come away with the rebound. Here's a shot put up by Tav Henry. He'll be fouled on the attempt. And it'll fall in, and one for Tav Henry. Going to call that foul on number 30, Jack Andrews of the Redhawks. And Taff Henry at the line shooting one. His attempt was no good, so that's a two-point lead for the Warhawks. And Pat Perry's going to drive and put it in. Pat Perry, challenged by two Warhawk defenders, finds a way to drive it and put it in. The big man, very versatile. Chapman shoots it for three while he's double-teamed, and he airballs it. So it's 26-26, and the Redhawks will have the ball back. Pat Perry with the ball. Passes it over to Hill. Hill's looking for a pass. Andrews for three. No good. Rebounded by Chapman. Chapman... dribble, drive, jump stop, puts it up, no good. And there's going to be a foul underneath the basket. They're going to call that on number 30 for the Warhawks on the rebound, Dakota Walls. Pat Perry's going to inbound it. That's Walls' first foul. Fourth foul for the Warhawks. And here's Jack Andrews with the ball now, bringing it across the timeline. Andrews looking for a pass or a drive. He'll pass it across the lane to Freeman for three. Freeman hits the three-point basket. Big three-point basket there from Freeman of the Redhawks. Pass inside. Intended for Dakota Walls, goes out of bounds. They're going to call that out of bounds on the Redhawks. And the Warhawks will inbound it underneath the goal. Logan Lloyd will be the inbounder. Here's Hoover. The pass over to Logan Lloyd. Lloyd shoots the three. It's no good. Here's Condry. Condry drives. Jump stop. No good. They're going to call him with the travel. Three minutes, 34 seconds to play in the half. Full court press is put on by both teams. Great defense, great offense as well. This is just an overall great basketball game. underneath the goal.
Dakota Walls
is going to put it up. He's going to go over Perry and put it up. And Perry's going to come away with the rebound or the inbound. And there's going to be a foul. They're going to call a foul on the floor. And Brady Corrin fouled Perry. That's Corrin's first foul. Inbound by Andrews. Andrews gets the ball back. He'll pass over to Hill. Hill looking to pass. Pass it to Andrews. Hill's going to drive. Pull up jumper. It's good. Hill makes the lead three once again. Chapman with the ball for the Warhawks now. Chapman spin move. He's going to kick it back out into the corner. That's Walls there. Walls is going to try to pass. It's going to be batted away by a Red Hawk. And they'll come away with the ball. Here's Pat Perry. Pat Perry spin move. Tries to put it up. Passes it out to Freeman. He tries the three. No good. And Chapman comes down with the rebound. Chapman and Walls. Chapman's going to drive. Spin move. Looking to pass. He'll pass it out. Here's Hoover. Hoover's pass. Over to Curran, no good. And Pat Perry is going to take it in himself. And there's going to be a foul. They're going to call that a block. Fouls on number 23, Brady Curran. That's his second foul, the team's sixth foul. 28-31, Pat Perry's at the line shooting two and he makes his first. 28-32.
Calvin, you want top or bottom? Duke, your bottom. 22 and the 32 high.
All the Red Hawks are in the backcourt except for Perry, who's at the line shooting. Perry's second shot on the way. Here it is. It's good. 33-28 the score. 2 minutes to play in the half. Here's Hoover. Hoover's driving. He's going to kick it back out. Chapman's with the ball now. Chapman's going to drive. He puts it up. No good. Rebound. No one can come down with it. They're going to call that out of bounds on the Warhawks. Red Hawks are going to get the basketball. Andrews with the inbound to Perry. Minute 45 to go. Pat Perry passes it across to Freeman. Freeman, they're going to call him with the travel. He took a step before he dribbled. And the Warhawks with the ball, 28-33. Inside pass to Hoover. Hoover tries to put it up. No good. Rebounded by Pat Perry. Perry's going to bring it down. He's going to try to score. Perry, spin move. No good. He'll pass it out to Andrews. Andrews to Freeman. Freeman for three! Freeman with the big three-point shot there to extend the lead to eight for the Red Hawks. A minute left in the half. Here's Hoover for three. No good. That's going to be rebounded by Bess. Pat Perry takes the ball across the timeline for the Red Hawks. Perry drives, puts it up, no good. Rebound by Bess. It's put back up by Bess, and Bess makes it. 10-point lead now.
What are you going for?
25 seconds on the shot clock, 31 seconds. Andrews takes the offensive foul for the Red Hawks. They're going to call that foul on Cody Hoover. That's his second foul, an offensive foul, and that's going to be seven fouls. And we'll pause to wipe some sweat up off the floor. Condry's going to come out of the game for the Red Hawks. Bess, Hill, Freeman, Perry, and Andrews out there for the Red Hawks now. We've got Henry, Chapman, Lloyd, Curran, and Hoover. for the Warhawks. Shot clock's been turned off. Pat Perry's going to dribble it. 15 seconds. Pat Perry looking to start some action now. Perry looking to drive. He'll pass it across to Freeman. Freeman for three. No good. And Andrews with the rebound. Andrews puts it up and time's going to expire. 28-38 heading into halftime after a big comeback by the Warhawks is thwarted by the Red Hawks defense and some great shooting. So we'll take halftime along with them. We'll be right back, folks. This is Lake Area Sports. Don't go away. We've got some great Thursday night boys basketball here from Mount Vernon Enola High School. This is Lake Area Sports, and I'm Jacob Cater. We'll be right back.
American Safeguard Insurance, you get an actual human being just down the street to get advice on the confusing world of insurance. There's no need to shop around every time your insurance company tries to raise rates. You can relax and let us do it for you. Having a choice is a big deal, and when insurance companies compete, you save money. One of the most important benefits is we actually monitor your premium for rate increases. If we notice a rate increase, we reshop your premium to ensure the best rate. And when the time comes to use your insurance, and we hope it doesn't, you have a friend to help guide you during one of the most stressful times of your life. All your needs under one roof, from vehicle to life insurance, and everything in between. We protect it all.
Took a 911 about 107 down a back road.
Hey folks, Sean Gorham here for Cowboy Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs, the Lake Area's fastest growing GM dealership, where we make your car buying experience easy and enjoyable. Simply shop cowboyscbg.com, where you can pick out your vehicle, get an appraisal, pre-approval, and even purchase from your living room. Every new vehicle purchased comes with a complimentary 7-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, and we deliver anywhere in the state. The service don't stop there. We also have a state-of-the-art service facility and collision repair center. So for all your automotive needs, come see us at Cowboys Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs.
Family Disco Pharmacy has been serving the Greers Ferry Lake area since 1976. They are located on the back side of the Court Square in downtown Heber Springs. Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy offers private consultations, Medicare enrollment, and immunizations for pneumonia, flu, COVID, shingles, tetanus, and more. They also test and treat strep and flu. Their staff is committed to providing fast and friendly service. Stop by today to see why Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy is Greer's Ferry Lake's number one independent pharmacy. FL Davis is more than just a hardware store. With six locations to serve you in Heber Springs, Greer's Ferry, Sherwood, Pea Ridge, Fayetteville, and Centerton, they're your one-stop shop for hardware and home improvement. They're also the home of the Lake Boutique, featuring clothing, footwear, jewelry, accessories, baby items, home decor, and kitchen items. Whether you're building a new home, improving your old one, or needing a gift for yourself or someone else, stop by one of their locations and experience all that they have to offer. Ivy Physical Therapy in Heber Springs is a proud supporter of the Lake Area Athletes. If you or your student athlete are looking to get back in shape or for therapy after an injury, give Ivy Physical Therapy a call at 501-362-8118 or visit ivyphysicaltherapy.com.
NAP Truss, they specialize in installation and creation of custom wood trusses for your home or business. NAP Truss utilizes only premier lumber to ensure our products will last. When you come to NAP Truss, you will have the peace of mind knowing you're receiving the best quality construction for the best price in the area. NAP Truss staff members have years in the industry and know what it takes to install a quality truss from the start finish. Call NAP Truss at 870-948-2105 today.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a...
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back for some second half action here at Mount Vernon Enola High School. The Nemo Vista Redhawks lead this game 38-28, 10-point lead over the Warhawks of Mount Vernon, the home team. These Redhawks led by Pat Perry inside the lane and underneath the goal, but also elsewhere on the floor. Great defensive player as well. Jack Andrews with the ball as Nemo Vista has it to start the half. They'll pass it over to Hill inside, and here's Freeman. Freeman been shooting. He's hot from the three-point line, three-point arch all night. Freeman looking to shoot, over to Andrews. Andrews to Hill. Hill to Andrews again. Andrews passes it down to Bess. And here's Freeman for three. No good. It's an air ball. Chapman's going to come away with the rebound for the Warhawks. He'll pass it before he gets